Hello everyone. In this video, we'll see what a recursive design parsing is. A recursive design parsing is a type of top-down parser where we start from the starting symbol, we keep on applying some predictions for each and every variable, and finally we derive to some set of input symbol. So that is a top-down parser, and recursive design parser is a basic top-down parser where the procedure for a recursive design parser is given in this thing. See, when you have a variable, when you have a variable at the topmost element, like for this variable, if you want to make a substitution, we choose a prediction for that variable, and here we have x1 to xk for all 1 to k. If this is a non-terminal, we are going to recursively call the procedure. We are going to substitute the prediction for this x1 in case that is called the procedure x, or in case if this x1 is a terminal symbol and if it is equal to the input symbol, we are going to advance the input symbol. So we are going to take the next input symbol and we take the next element to proceed the same process, or else it is an error condition. But the problem here is, like, we have only one prediction for A. If it is only one prediction for a variable, then it is fine, but that never occurs in a real-time environment. And in case if you have two or more prediction for a variable, then we have to choose which prediction to be replaced next. In such a cases, we need backtracking. Actually, backtracking is if something goes wrong, we have to go back to the previous step and we have to choose another prediction for a variable. I'll give an example for this. Consider a prediction like this: S tends to CAD and this A tends to ABRB. If we are deriving a parse tree using a recursive design parser, the input we consider is CAD. It is a top-down parser. We have to start with the starting symbol X, and for S we have only one prediction, so we have to replace this with CAD. So now the first element is a terminal symbol, and we have to compare this terminal symbol with the input, and they are same. If they are same, no problem. We have to proceed with the next element. And the next element is A. For A, we have two different predictions. So when you have two different predictions, we have to take one at a time. So we start with this first prediction. So in this, A can be replaced with AB. Now when you compare this with the input symbol, this A and this A matches. But here in the parse tree which we derive, we have B. But actually in the input, we have D. So there is a mismatch between the input and the parse tree. So in that case, what happened, this recursive design parser will backtrack a step. So the problem arises while choosing a prediction for A. So what happened, it chose another prediction for A. So it starts with S. So this will remain as it is. For this A, instead of substituting AB, it checks for another substitution. So this process is called backtracking, going a step ahead and choose another possible prediction for substitution. So now when you replace this A with A, we can compare it with the input symbol. So A and A matches, and the next input is D, D and D matches. So that is end of input and this tree is complete. So this is a parse tree thing. In case if you have some other thing, if none of the prediction for A is satisfying the condition, then we have to check another possibility for S. So what happened, for S we don't have any other prediction, so that is an error case. So in order to check whether the error occurs in a prediction or not, we have to check all possible conditions. So grammar that I have taken is a very simple one. In case if it is a greater prediction, then we need so much of backtracking for analyzing the error in a code. And again, we have one more important problem, that is left recursion. When in a grammar, if you have a prediction of S tends to S, so this is an error case. What happened, for this S, we keep on substituting. So this is a recursive design parsing, right? So for this S, we substitute this prediction with S. And again, for this S, it substitutes the prediction for S. So we cannot go to check for backtracking itself, since none of the variable derives to a terminal symbol, whereas we can compare it with this. So it goes into an infinite loop. So these are the problems that we face in a recursive design parsing. So we are going for the next parser, that is predictive parser. Thank you.